Post independence, Surat was considered as one of the filthiest city of the country with a lot of challenges of health.
In 1994, the story is that they had catastrophic floods, which then led to an ensuing plague outbreak. And those two things, the combined effects of those, were that leadership had to be catalyzed around how to respond.
It was a time when the city had to decide whether we should die or we should survive.
Surat prem karva jevu j sheher chhe. સુરતની જે જમીન છે
એન્ડ વી આર ઓન ધ મેપ ઓફ ઓલ હેઝાર્ડ્સ સી લેવલ રાઈઝ ફ્લડ અર્થક્વેક વી હેવ લાર્જ ઇન્ડસ્ટ્રીઝ અરાઉન્ડ અસ સો સિટી નીડ્સ ટુ બી પ્રિપેર્ડ
એન્ડ ઇન લાસ્ટ 100 યર્સ વી હેવ હેડ 23 રિપોર્ટેડ ફ્લડ્સ સો વી ઓલ ન્યુ દેટ ફ્લડ ઇઝ અ રિકરિંગ ફિનોમિના 2006 આઈ સ્ટીલ રિમેમ્બર ઇટ વોઝ 6th ઓફ ઓગસ્ટ એન્ડ મંડે એન્ડ ફ્લડ વોઝ ટુ કમ People were anxious, and what is going to be the intensity of the flood, we never knew. By 4 o'clock in the afternoon, almost 50% of the city was flooded. And on the following day, we found out that 75% of the city was underwater.
But during that time also, having that experience of how to handle disasters, the city came back in normalcy within a week, and some of the emergency services like drinking water were restored within a span of 36 hours. So I think the spirit of the people, it gives the strength to the city for resilience.
આનો પ્રતિકાર દરેક ક્ષેત્રથી થવો જોઈએ. ફક્ત તંત્ર એકલું એમના પહોંચી ન વળે.
So what Surat already had was a very active citizenship, it had very active administration, it had institutions that cared, and somehow they had created an environment in which you had a lot of different stakeholders.
Amara apna Gujarat na tatkalin mukhyamantri na chara desh na vada pradhan adarniya Narendra Bhai Modi sahab no pan aaj ek concept che emnu disha suchan pan aaj che ke jan bhagidari thi.
So when we arrived in 2008 with the Asian Cities Climate Change Resilience Network, they were a ready and willing partner. They were like, this is exactly what we need.
I think one of the challenges here is to find ways to effectively leverage and build on the work, particularly with ACERN. They've done a lot of thinking around climate resilience. They have a number of initiatives, some of which they've implemented and to great success, such as the early warning system with respect to river flooding and dam releases.
We will be in a position to predict how the flood is going to come, when the flood is going to come, the intensity of the flood and people who are likely to be affected.
And I think the icing on the cake has been now them expanding their horizons beyond the climate and floods issue to think more widely even about resilience, and that's really what 100 Resilient Cities brought in. And I think that's why they were a successful applicant first time round, because people could see when they were assessing Surat that there's real energy and dynamism here. They understand that this is really central to their future.
We have to consider that everything is done keeping resilience in mind. So now it is a step going from reactive to proactive.